Good evening, fellow Singaporeans and voters of Jalan Besar GRC. In 2006, the Workers' Party's slogan was, "You have a choice." In 2011, it was towards a first world parliament. This year, it is empower your future. I would like to use these to show you three ways the Workers' Party is different from the PAP. First, we are different from the PAP because we respect your vote. The PAP does not. The Workers' Party has offered you a choice for many years. However, the PAP has diluted your choice and often made it very difficult for you to choose the MPs you really want in Parliament. GRCs were first introduced because the PAP claimed that they were needed to ensure minority representation. Then, GRCs were expanded, supposedly to take advantage of economies of scale in running town councils. But they are actually being used to bring in candidates to Parliament under the protection of a minister. We disagree with GRCs. GRCs dilute your vote. GRCs dilute your voice. The PAP also introduced nominated members of Parliament to put different voices into Parliament. But nominated MPs are not elected by you. They are selected by a committee dominated by the ruling party. And most sadly, the PAP had threatened you that voting for opposition would put you at the end of the queue for estate upgrading. For the courageous voters who continued to defy them and voted in opposition MPs, the PAP meted out punishment. The Workers' Party does not want your voting rights to be eroded. We would never threaten you to get your vote. We recommend in our manifesto that both GRCs and nominated MPs should be abolished. And if the Workers' Party ever comes into power, we would abolish both schemes even though they would favour us. Second, we differ from the PAP because we believe that Parliament must have a strong opposition entrenched in it. The PAP thinks it's perfectly fine for one party to occupy all the seats. In 2011, we said that Singapore should move towards a first world parliament. That call is still relevant today. We only had 7 out of the 87 seats in the last parliament, less than 10%. A strong opposition provides much needed competition and can challenge the ruling party when it is in the best interest of the people to do so. Numbers count. The PAP tells us that their backbenchers raise issues and criticize the government. They claim that they can check themselves. But is that believable? The PAP tells us that their backbenchers can be a check, but can they truly be a check? They are called backbenchers for a reason. It is the PAP ministers sitting in the front who make the policy. Even if the PAP MPs speak up, can they vote when their party leaders decide on something? No! Letting them check themselves is giving them a blank check. It is not enough to check the government by having voices in Parliament. To protect Singaporeans, you must also check the government with votes. Third, the Workers' Party differs from the PAP because we do not think that the government should infiltrate every aspect of life. The PAP obviously thinks they should control everything. The PAP places government representatives in all areas of Singapore life, including sports, business, and professional groups. The PAP wants Singaporeans to be dependent on them, but there is more than enough talent in the private sector to drive things. In fact, Singapore may be able to achieve better results if the PAP would get out of certain areas. Let's take sports. Since we are in Jalan Besar GRC, let's talk about football. In the early days of Singapore's nationhood, the Singapore football team was a force to be reckoned with on the international stage. Can you imagine that in 1966, Singapore was fourth in the Asian Games, behind only Burma, Iran, and Japan? Fourth in the whole of Asia, not just Southeast Asia. In the 1970s, the whole nation was riveted behind our boys in blue in their quest to win the Malaysia Cup. Everyone had football fever, not just the soccer fans, but even grandmothers and housewives too. I remember as a young child, diligently cutting out newspaper articles and pictures of our footballers and keeping my own scrapbook. We fought so hard and mightily and had bitter disappointments. But finally, in 1977, Singapore beat Penang 3-2 to become Malaysia Cup champions. And I am so proud that the man who headed in the winning goal is here with us tonight as my personal driver. In those days, the Football Association of Singapore was headed by people who were not politicians. They were passionate about the game and relied on their own networks to bring in coaches and technical expertise. They even poured in their own money at times to achieve their dreams. Where is Singapore soccer today? According to the rankings by football's world governing body, FIFA, Singapore dropped from number 70 in the world in 1993 to a new low this year of 157 in the world. We are classified by FIFA as one of the worst movers down the rankings. What went wrong? The FAS constitution now states that all council members shall first be appointed by a cabinet minister before being confirmed by an election. For the last 20 years, the minister decided to place a PAP MP in charge of the Football Association. Looking at how our rankings have nosedived over the last 20 years, is this policy working? The sports minister should be committing harakiri. Now, I'm not belittling the efforts of our current footballers or their coaches. It is the structure I'm questioning. And now FIFA has been critically looking at the structure of the FAS as it believes officials of football associations should be freely elected. Just 2 days ago, on September 1st, FIFA told our FAS to put their internal elections on hold over possible government interference. It is embarrassing that it takes an international body to highlight a problem that has been simmering for so long. It is time for Singaporeans to take charge of what we care about. Let our passion take us to greatness. We have done it before, and we can do it again. My friends, power has made the PAP more and more arrogant. They think they can tell us who should represent us, not just in parliament, but also in sports and even in business groups and the professions. They want to control every aspect of our life. If we become totally dependent on the PAP, how can Singapore be a dynamic nation? This election, we must bring the power back to the people. Send a strong message to the PAP that Singaporeans want to be free from their arrogance, their control, and their threats. Empower your future. On 11 September, vote for the Workers' Party.